Nah, punya topik itu ya. Jadi punya topik modul number 7 ya, 7 intellectual property. Intellectual property online umum. Semua nampak slide ya? Ha? Nampak tak slide? Ada tak?
Nampak.
Okey, okey. So, alatlah. Dah masuk dah modul 7 already. Almost finish kita ada. Ada lagi coming. Mana? Okey, Nur Hidayah pula. Sudah masuk ke dunia. Okey. Ya. Lagi kami. Kalau yang datang ni, saya kena stop lah. Bukan boleh ni. Itu dia punya. Okey. Okey, mana ni? Mana ni? Okay, alright. So topic today ya, the unit 7 ataupun modul yang ke-7 that we going to talk about today is intellectual property. In Malay we call it harta intellect. So what the company possess, harta. Definitely what we have heard before, traditionally kalau we talk about harta property, businesses we thought that they only have a physical assets, benda yang dalam bentuk tangible, dalam bentuk tangible ni benda yang ketara lah, that means something that we can touch. Of course we know lah what are those tangible asset, physical asset, like what in business, some of the business they possess what they own, land, buildings, equipment, and that's most important, and machine whatever lah. So anyhow, it looks that today is going to be different. We know that those companies even do not own this what we call it physical asset or tangible asset. They're still worth more. That's what we call it. The address we talk with intellectual asset. Which is of course very important today. Okay. So that is a topic that we're doing. So what is in general, what is intellectual property in general? So intellectual property, is any product of human intellect. Any product of human intellect. Okay, that is tangible. That is intangible, but not tangible. That is intangible. Intangible ni mana harta yang tak ketara lah. Tangible. Intangible, not tangible. But of course, they has what? They has value in the marketplace. Walaupun tak tangible, tapi there is value in the marketplace. So that's why any product is of and the product of human intellect and creative endeavor, such as what, of course, what are those forms of what we call it, forms of the call intellectual property, include innovation, design, whatever you come up with a design, you have your own style of doing business style, you come up with the artistic word, or you have a literary word, all those, if they have value in the marketplace, that we call it is intellectual property. Okay, as you know, of course, It is called intellectual. Why the term is called intellectual? Because what? Because it is the product of human imagination. Because it involves your imagination, people's imagination, human creativity, and even inventiveness. That's why we call it intellectual property. So the word, that's the word comes in, the intellectual property. Okay. So it is called, what? Intellectual. To means to portray or anything, because the product itself, the product that you come up is what? Involve human imagination. And when you allow, whenever you come up with a product that in your group, of course, something that you have to imagine, you have to create, and you have to have come up with your own creativity and your invention, inventiveness. Okay. So as I said before, of course, this area is very important, because despite the what I call it, we understand we talk about property, we always refers to the physical asset, but there is other asset which is another very important matter for today and in future, there is intellectual property. Okay. Right. So the intellectual creations and its inherent value can be protected. Whatever the company own, which is, even though it's not the physical asset, can be protected from being exploited by other parties, because we know there is value about it, and it's worth not even million but billion of today, certain of the intellectual creation today. So we can refer a lot. We can find out, even you Google, find out there's a worth of even to the extent of billions of dollars if we try to look about the what we call it, those well-known company today. So the concept of intellectual property means that any unauthorized use of creation, if someone use without your authority, okay, or works by an authorized party, is prohibited and protected by law. So I mean, that's why when we talk about it, there is something that needs to be protected. Then of course it's going to be more value of it from being exploited by other parties. Okay. All right. So okay, very specific when you look about this definition. So earlier I mentioned about what is intellectual property in general, but from the legal perspective here, definition of intellectual property, they thought is what is defined as the legal entitlement attached to the express form of, in the form, it can be an idea or to the some other intangible subject matter that enables its holder, that means owner, to exercise exclusive control over the use IP. So that is a definition from the perspective of law perspective, or even those defined by those what we call it, enforcement agency in the country. In of course, in our country is by my IPO, IPO, now this Perbadanan Intellect Malaysia. Okay, so Perbadanan Harta Intellect Malaysia. Okay, so that is the definition. That means intellectual property what? Is a legal entitlement attached to the express form of idea. When you have idea, okay, that is you have the legal right on that, or to the other whatever intangible asset that enable, if you are the owner, to exercise exclusive control. That means other people cannot exercise. That means prohibit other people using your whatever property, intellectual property that you own. Okay, right. So let's go to the types of intellectual property, or another key forms of intellectual property. In fact, if you refer even to the Malaysia or other country, they may have many forms, but in general of course there are we discuss only five types of intellectual property, or the other, or I used to call it the key forms. Types ataupun key forms of intellectual property. Sama lah tu lah. Forms ataupun types. There are five types or five forms of intellectual property. a right which provides protection for invention or creation against infringement. Infringement like this, infringement ni pelanggaran lah. That means someone use without your authority. Okay, so we need to protect this. So what are the five types or what are the key forms of intellectual property? So the first one kita semua tahu lah. We used to talk every day. All this, we are very familiar. Except we go very deep lah. Not to the extent very deep. Of course, this takes you're going to be a patent attorney because those who specialize in this legal, of course, they have very specialized fee in this. In fact, in other developed countries, they have a patent attorney or patent lawyer on this, because it involves a lot of legal way of protecting this. Okay, so the first types of intellectual property is patent. Second, we're going to discuss, of course, copyright, trademark, industrial design, and trade secret. We refer, maybe there are other types of intellectual, but we only discuss here only five, which is of course the typical intellectual property that we used to know. Of course, you refer to the website of the agency involved in managing or exercising this IP. I used to IP. We talk, when I refer to IP, I talk about intellectual property. Yeah, semua boleh follow tak semua ni? Boleh. Hello everybody.
Boleh.
Tapi familiar, but now we cannot take for granted lah. It's very important even up today. Eh? Alright, even it's related to your project lah. Because you also have to mention at what stage your product developed or future what you're going to do about your project. So kita pernah dengar lah, we have heard certain companies in order to retain or to survive or to grow in the future, they have to protect whatever property or intellectual property that they have. Okay, to the extent some of this, they combine everything in one. If you have read, so I have read a certain article about the US company when they establish organization against people make use or infringe their product. So they go for this all in combination. It's possible go for all. So there's a lot of example of this. Okay, in Malaysia, very specific lah, in Malaysia, technological inventions are protected under Patent Act 1983. There are acts, of course, that protects. So, right. So the acts cover two key forms of protection. They are the different types. The types of patent, types of key form in Malaysia. One is they call it patent. Yang ni kalau kita nak go very big, sebenarnya patents ataupun this is a patent. If I can add, but I cannot add lah because this is a law. But this patent, it means that like a standard patent. Satu ni nak to distinguish between the first, that is a first form of apa? Patents punya protection. One type is we call it patent or AKA. So this is what we call it standard patent. Okay. The other one is utility innovation or maybe kita panggil utility punya apa? Utility punya patent. Okay. Itu dua lah. So dia try to share. Dalam Malaysia ni, dalam Act di Malaysia Cover Act ada dua patent. There are two types of patent. Patent which is standard patent, satu lagi okay, utility punya innovation ataupun utility patent. Okay, apa beza dua ni? So kita let's explore lah. Okay, ini we talk about the standard patent lah. So a patent is an exclusive right granted for invention. So when you invent something, either a product or process. So that product process should be the one of something of new lah. Otherwise, you cannot go for what for what you know cannot apply for patent lah. So a patent is exclusive right granted for invention which is a product or process that provides a new way of doing some things, new way of doing some things, or offers a new technical solution to problem. In product, definitely we can see the physical thing lah. You go and patent the product. Like you have bicycle, you go patent it. Definitely there's a lot of design or description about your product. I mean the picture, the drawing of your product, and even the process. Or those who venture in a service business, that means they can patent the process of the product or service. Okay. Okay. According to bear in mind, but the product that that product or process that can be patented here is something that of that is new thing or something that's offer a new technical solution to a problem. Okay. According to Patent Act 1983, a patent is intellectual property granted to inventor, giving him or her the exclusive right to make. Okay, so the idea of getting a patent of according to the law, is what to give right to the inventor the exclusive right to make, use, or sell invention for how long? For a limited time period of 20 years. 20 years. I mean, whenever you have the right, you the authority approve your application for patent. Then you have the exclusive right. Many other people they do not have the right at all. Okay, all right. Okay, and I come. That is a what I call it patent ataupun saya selalu panggil standard patent lah. Standard patent. Okay. How many years? 10 years. Okay. Another types of patent ataupun key form of patent. Ini kalau di US dipanggil macam-macam lagi patent lah. Tapi di Malaysia ada another one is utility innovation. Utility innovation. Okay. So when we talk the word utility, of course something that you come up with what? Something that is what different from those exist in the market lah. But of course is I think something that is of course will satisfy the customer lah. All right, so but here utility innovation is, or utility innovation as the most I used to call it utility patent also, is an exclusive right granted for a minor invention. So compared to the patent, which is of course the general one, the standard patent, utility patent is also the right, exclusive right granted for minor, only for minor invention, which does not require to satisfy the test of inventiveness as required of a patent. A patent, what I mean, a patent is standard patent. Meaning that, of course, if you go through, you want to apply for the standard patent, it's going to be, detail to get to get your right. But here because it's a minor, of course they're going to not be as stringent as the applying for the standard patent. So utility innovation provides intellectual property right for those incrementers. We knew that before. Most of the innovation today is more on incremental. Very rare lah find out here those innovation which is of course what we call radical or breakthrough innovation. So normally if that's fall under incremental, and of course those innovation is still low or lower level innovation, that would not be sufficient inventive to qualify a standard patent. So that's why it goes under utility innovation. Okay, because what, as we know that most automation today, or even in your project, maybe if you project, if you can, it will be fall under this category, like under these types of what we call it, patent, patent ataupun so utility. So because why we call it utility? This due to the inventory threshold of being lowered compared to standard patent. That is, utility innovation required while an innovative action rather than inventive action. And something you innovate from the existing one, some or some dose of improvement, but still new product, but still can fall under this under. But as I know that, of course, to go through, maybe there is also regulation that for those inventor earlier, maybe they have the there is possibility that we have to get another word approval lah, approval from those main inventor before, but likely not lah, but there's a case happen. So that is utility patent. So you can check through lah. I think most of the product that developed today, majority of them fall under this utility, utility. But still, all those under patent. In general, what? In general, people always talk about this. Have you patented your product? Of course, they don't know go to detail that is under what utility patent atau utility division. But of course, they are still under apa? Still under Patent Act, Patent Act. Okay. So why you need to protect? That's how important it is for you to protect your what you call it, innovation. Why you have to protect an invention? A patent or utility innovation protection gives you, gives the owner of the patent or utility innovation exclusive right to stop others from manufacturing, using, and selling the owner invention in Malaysia without the owner's consent or permission. And then no other party easily can what we call it manufacture or even use or sell whatever invention. Those invention, of course, is already be patented in Malaysia without the owner's consent. So if they go about it, of course, they will be subject to what? Subject to litigation or subject to what we call it, being sued lah. Being sued by those owner. Okay. So as the owner, why you need to put that? You have the right. Owner has the patent owner. Maksudnya patent, bukan gitu. Patent owner has the right to use the patented invention. Of course, be the owner, of course, you have the right legally, or if you do not want to use, maybe we have heard also those patent owner, they may license to other parties to use the invention. License, call with fees, license to other parties to use it. And or even sell the right of the invention to someone else who will then become the new owner of the patent. Itu kemungkinan lah. To commercialize or to get reward of what the patent that they own, they can choose to use the patent, or they may have to may license it, or they may have may decide to sell the right or the invention to someone else, get the whole sum, or we become the new owner of the patent. So many things. But first, most important, you have to be the owner patent. Okay, owner of the patent. Who can apply for a patent? Any person may make an application for a patent or for a utility innovation, either alone or jointly with another person. So the word person is not limited to natural person, that's the good economy. So as we know lah, in business, sometimes when we apply not in the, on individual basis. Some of this patent apply on the basis of company. So because the company also is another entity in the business, they can enter into an agreement. So that's why here they thought that the person is not only limited to natural person, that means the body of the person. It can be a company, company to company, or the company to apply. And then maybe there are company like what? whatever your company name, you apply on the capacity as a company, not as capacity as a person. But there are cases someone apply on the capacity as a person or persons. Okay, it depends. Right. So if the company apply, that means the company have the right for the patent. If the person apply, the person has the right to the patent. So whichever, of course, in real business, normally the company apply, especially for those at least sendirian berhad company lah, sendirian berhad company, and of course they prefer, because not prefer, they are supposed to apply under a company to get a patent. Okay. As a guideline, for those patent, what kind of what are the criteria that you have to satisfy for your product or for your invention to be patented? So this is among it. So I think this also, if you develop the product, maybe you, when you develop or you want to describe your product, make sure all these criteria maybe should be, you should bear in mind. Don't forget, because as it is, any product, because you already, when you develop the product, or you, another word, or in your case for your NPD product, or for your blueprint product, make sure if your product is meant for patented, so you should satisfy the this following criteria. For you to qualify lah, or you to qualify to get a patent. Okay, what the first criteria, or maybe ini juga boleh you gunakan guideline lah untuk explain you punya product. Jangan lupa lah, satu daripada one of the criteria here is what, the first criteria here is what, functional or technical. Your invention must relate to how something works. Maknanya you must explain how your product works, what it does, what it is made of, or how it is made. Jadi, definitely if you already have all this information, describe all this, there is, not only you describe your product, but of course it's also, macam serampai dua mata, it's also meant for you to get approval for the patent. Okay? Maknanya clearly you mention about the function or the technical aspect of your product, which is of course something about how something works, mana how your product works. Or what it does and what it is made of and how it is made. And okay, another criteria to be patented, otherwise maybe your application for it will be rejected. Something of your product is new. New dalam konteks ni lah, dalam konteks patent ni lah. Tapi dalam konteks kita belajar ni, akademik, of course kita tak maju pun lagi. Jangan so cepat balik. Dalam konteks pattern ini, new definition lain. The invention has not been publicly disclosed in any form, in anywhere in the world. Jangan cepat-cepat kita public, masuk dalam YouTube ke apa semua sekali lah kononnya. Tapi you nak present ke saya, kena hantar ke saya link. Of course, you kena bagi link. But of course, I will not disclose lah in any form, anywhere in the world. Because that is your property, kata. The invention has not been publicly disclosed any form. Because kalau satu dah public, kata dalam Facebook or whatever it is, when people is already known to the public, that is not qualified lah. That means it's already, orang kata dah basi lah. Or of course people will copy it. But that is the worst thing lah. Something that is not original to you, not novel, okay? Alright, another criteria here, involve an inventive action. The invention that could not be figured out by a person with average knowledge of the technical field. Apa maksud di sini? Maknanya, your invention ni, something of different. Maknanya, like what you invent today or you try to innovate, come out your product. Something that you have to explain. Maknanya, like people like me, maybe I don't understand more lah about your product. Because it's not easy, because you are more familiar, you know well about your product, how the product is made, and of course if like other person, okay, Then your product, you invest something that easily can be copied or easily can be copied those that people are not technical, that is not inventive action. So maknanya something that is unique is another word here. Something that is unique. Okay. Okay. Alright. The idea of course, kita dah mention tadi, mana intellectual property mesti ada apa? Must have a value, something that we can be marketed. So that's why industrially applicable. The invention must be capable of being made. Kena not only kita imagine saja, but it's not practical. You cannot make. You take a lot on it, but it's not possible to make or use in industry. It can be mass produced, able to be made. Mana you can talk about product, but practically at the end it's not made. It cannot be made, and of course, it cannot be used in industry. So because the idea of everything is meant to market it. The idea is a product that we develop is to market it. If you have no value, it's no point to patent. That's why we have heard that as cases, people do not know. People do not know. There's a mistake, there's common mistake for me when they want to protect their property. There are so many common mistakes that people make when they want to protect their intellectual property. Okay. All right. One of course, in this case, of course, you have to legally lah, legal protect. Otherwise, someone may use your patent, patent. All right. Okay. The one that we talk about, okay. All right. There non-patentable invention. There are cases, the patent which cannot be invention that cannot be patented. Non-coded, of course. Discovery, something that is those scientific theories and mathematical models, or literary, dramatic, musical, artist work, that is not cannot be another word, do not fall under patent, under patent. Because that one, like literary, drama, music, that is fall under different, under what we call it copyright. Copyright. Okay. So we have to look at it, which of course is meant for patent. So this among the what? Invention, but it's not patentable. Cannot be patented. Plant or animal varieties, or essentially biological processes for the production of plants or animals other than man-made living microorganisms, microbiological processes, and the product of such microorganism processes. Okay. Schemes, rules, or methods for doing business. Performing purely mental acts or playing games cannot be protected. So the presentation of invention or some computer. So you may realize all this are listed here. They may fall under different what? Different types of intellectual property. Different types or different forms of intellectual property. Methods. This to show you the to distinguish which is patented or which is not patented. Okay. Methods for the treatment of human or any animal body for surgery or therapy or diagnostic. Methods practice on the human or animal body. Okay. All right. And anything immoral or contrary to public policy, or something that cannot be patented. Okay. Right. There is a basic rules, basic guideline here. To pursue a patent, among the patent expert, they recommend we follow basic guideline. Rule number one, you want to pursue patent first. Pursue patent that are broad or commercially significant and offer a strong position. Okay. You cannot be very specific lah. In other words, broad, that means everybody, it covers a lot. Maybe cover your pattern can be what we call it, in other words, widely spread lah. Not only, maybe not only in Malaysia, but other country, okay? And is it all commercially significant? That means can be commercialized. You, if you take out the way, if this rule, that's not, it's not commercially significant, I cannot commercialize it. Or when you go for patent, the patent doesn't give you a strong position of your product. It's no point to go for patent. Okay. The patent must be significant, novel or proprietary. Maknanya your patent ni something that is novel. Novel ni maknanya benda yang different lah. Different from ataupun original. In sense the product that you going to, or the venture that you going to go for, something of original or different from others product di pasaran or proprietary. Patent tu mana yang akan jadi lah. Simply your proprietary, your milik. Proprietary ni milik you lah. Milik syarikat atau milik individu industri. So when you go for this, pursue it, make sure the product that you going to patented, you record and help them witness so that the community secure proprietary position. Because first place, maknanya to take care of your patent in future in case it will happen in the future, maknanya people use your exclusive right, the patent right ni, then when you have the, what I call it, the document, the proof that the patent that you have need something that is there, you have gone through. That's why when you go to the patent or when you develop something or product, record and have them witness so that documentation secure proprietary position, secure proprietary to get to, because when you apply to get that something else, how you going to justify that is your product. Maybe kita pernah dengar kalau dalam movie, some of this use the what? They use the tapping. Tapping atau ada yang tulis, ada yang witness, to justify, to prove something of the pattern that go for it is something of something that is not only that novel, original of yours or proprietary of yours. Okay. Okay, the rule number two here, this recommended by the patent expert. Prepare, and of course, when you prepare patent plan. Okay, prepare. So you have to come up with a plan in detail, and your plan should outline the cost to develop, how much it costs, the cost to develop, and how much also the cost to market the innovation. To prove that you have done something, of course, of your patent in detail, prepare patent plan, get the plan, and together, of course, in the plan also outline the cost involved in developing and market the. So in the plan also, you have also come up with how you analyze competition and technological similarity. So maknanya to prove that is something that is the plan also come up with a detail telling that you already taking into consideration your competitors and the technologies similarities of the ideas that you have. And of course so you have to detail out the perceived value, the precise value, precise value of the innovation, not perceived, silap, the perceived precise. Precise value, nilai yang sebab tepat yang boleh. Detail out the precise value of the innovation. Okay, that's the second one to pursue a patent. Okay. Another third rule or guideline here. Rule number three here, together pursue a patent. Have your action relate to your original patent. Stick to the original patent plan during the early stages of establishing the patent. Because maknanya you keep on changing your application for patent, that may, it's got to be, maybe it will delay the process, stick to Roger plan during the early stages of sibling pattern. At later stage, the plan may change. You can change later stage. Example, in the pattern, you talk about, mentioned dalam criteria patterning or application, you say this pattern is meant to for licensing, or maybe for your personal use. That is may, after maybe you get approval on it, okay? Okay, the fourth one, establishment and infringement budget. Mana the 8 cases, we know that the people look when your product is good and the when your product is good. There is cases maybe someone may what we call it infringe. Infringing maknanya melanggar lah. Infringement ni banyak melanggar atau mungkin make use of your patent without your authorization. So, in fact, certain company, they keep aside already certain budget. Infringer, make a failure. They afraid mana company tak boleh main kan. This company may take legal action or legal damages if someone use their punya pattern. So infringer may fear legal damages because what? Because you may have a budget, infringement budget, mana budget in case someone may copy or may use your exclusive rights. Okay. Thus preparing this budget for prosecuting violation of the mana is already taking care already. Yeah? Dah ambil kira dah semua ni. Okay, just mana if there is someone possibly they're going to use your pattern, we have the budget for it. Itulah, keep aside certain amount of budget for you. Habis some of the small business they can afford because certain when someone copy, if you go for the litigation, saman balik tu maybe involve lot of cost, kadang sampai beratus-ratus ribu. Itu yang jadi kalau mas company kecil jadi mangsa. Tapi professionally kalau di US, thing like this will not happen because for big company normally dia very less realistic. Dia go and maybe negotiate and buy your patent whatever lah. First amount if they really want to use the patent. Okay, the last one of here. After you have done the rule number 5, yeah, evaluate the pattern strategically. Okay, we go apply for a pattern, it takes longer time, and typically it takes 3 years. Mana we did that range lah, tiga tahun ni maknanya 36 bulan lah, lama jugalah. Pattern process typically take 3 years, 36 month. Ada yang early, tapi this typical lah, 36 month and the longer. Okay, compare this 3 years. Okay, if you want to apply, maknanya to get the patent, maknanya lah, okay, we have to wait, kata, sampai 36 bulan. Okay, imagine yourself, compare this this with the life cycle of the proposed innovation. Okay, if you go for patent, apply for patent, of course, it will cost you a lot. And during that three years, and then you get maybe katalah at the end of on the 36 month you get the approval and get the patent right. Okay, compare this the life cycle of the proper innovation. Okay, will the patent be worth defending in 3 years or will enforcement cost more than the remedies? Maknanya kalau within that 3 years someone copy and you want to sue, okay. Alright, and then kalau life cycle more than that, I mean life cycle of your innovation is more than 3 years, of course definitely it's going to be, useful lah, go for the patent. But kalau dalam one ni, then you want to defend it, is it worth not? If you get katalah you get only doing that 3 years, you get income ataupun whatever lah, from their patent only katalah 300,000. Tapi with that, after 3 years, it's already, the product is cycle, is already, there's no demand of your product. So, someone copy, or I mean someone infringe your patent, then, apa lagi? And you have to spend more than income that you generate, a profit you get, generate 400,000, maybe 500,000, it's not worth to what you call it to go for patent, to comparison lah. Maybe some of those prefer people go for patent for longer period. Okay, alright. There is a rules. Cakap tadi, equally to expert lah. They recommend the following basic guideline or basic rules. So here we have the 5 basic rules in order for you to go for or to pursue a patent. Okay, kita dah mention tadi. How long the patent can be protected? Term of protection. So patent is protected 20 years from the date of filing, the date of application lah. When you go for ni, so once you approach sebenarnya 20 years from the date of filing. Meaning that after 20 years, you are no longer the owner lah. People can exclusively use your right. Yeah? Your right. So maknanya, if you sue the company after 20 years, the product is already in the market, after you get the patent, it's no longer valid. Eh? Jadi kalau kita don't have any idea, 20 years is gone. If someone look about the product that 20 years ago, misalnya obsolete lah. But of course, people make again of this product now, then of course they are not subjected to ni lah. Legal punya circumstances. Okay. Itu untuk pattern, standard pattern. Tapi ada satu lagi pattern, kata kalau di Malaysia ni kata utility innovation atau utility pattern yang tadi kita kata standard pattern. Ingat lah, kita ada tadi di Malaysia ni ada 2 types of pattern. Satu standard pattern or pattern here in general, or utility innovation ataupun utility pattern ya. Still under pattern semua. Bahasa umum memang kita panggil pattern lah. Patentable innovation is protected 10 years from the date of filing. Dia punya protected 10 years. Tapi the term may be extended twice. Maksudnya, we can go after expired 10 years, we can go for extension, ask for protection another 5 years. And after that, another 5 go another. At the end, sampai juga sama juga. Subject to use. Because sometimes this incremental punya innovation, they cannot last long. Kita tahu kan. That's why maybe they'll go for the shorter period of time. Then you can extend further 5 and we can add more further 5. Therefore, the protection is also 20 years. Kita can end up only for 10 years. But of course, we have the choice and the option to go for the extension. So one patent expires. The owner no longer holds the exclusive right to the invention. Once the patent expired, the owner no longer holds the exclusive right. Maksudnya kalau cakap tadi, kalau expired after 20 years, you as the owner have no right at all lah to the invention, unless you reapply and get your reply. But most of the product today, sebenarnya normally they are not going to apply lah because they are going to keep innovating kan, innovating atau creating new product or developing new product. Okay, there is term of protection for patent. How long? 20 years and another validity is 10 years plus 5 and plus 5. Okay. Ni tak apa-apa itulah sebab dia punya ni dia maklumat ni dah out of date. I think kita boleh check through internet. Maybe dia punya amount pun dah berubah dah. Di surat ni tak valid lah. Dia punya address pun saya nampak pun salah jugalah. Dia bukan di menara dari bumi dah. Saya rasa dah lain dah. Tak apa, sekarang ni kita boleh check sendiri lah. Dia kata anyhow, yang sebenarnya kata an applicant must file a patent or utility innovation with the Intellectual Property Corporation of Malaysia. So ada badan yang meluluskan atau menerima ada meluluskanlah patent di Malaysia, dipanggilnya Intellectual Property Corporation of Malaysia, or in Malay dipanggil Perbadanan Harta Intelek Malaysia. Dia ada di Kuala Lumpur dan juga ada di Cawangan. Ini kita up to date yang terbaru, saya tak update sekarang ni. Tapi maknanya kalau kita nak update, kita rasa buka tu jugalah. Buka apa, buka Google tu, buka website dia lah. So website dia bukan MIPC kan. Sekarang organisasi ni dia dikenali sebagai MyIPO. MyIPO. IPO tu IP lah, organisation. MyIPO. So dia punya amar pun lain. So yang ni ingat figure, telefon number semua ni tak valid lah. Tak valid, jadi kita kena cari yang terbaru lah. Kena praktis cari baru kalau kita nak. Mana application masih lagi untuk registrar. The pattern is the office. Office tu dah. Tapi tempatnya bukan, saya rasa bukan di sini lagi lah. Saya pernah tinggal lama, saya rasa it's not this Menara Dai Bumi. Maybe dia dah move ke lain tempat lah. Sebab mana saya pun tak familiar, saya pun tak check semua ni, okay. Dia boleh check lah. So dia punya address pun tak betul lah. Address dia punya website tu bukan MIPC, dia sebenarnya MyIPO. MYIPO. Kalau kita key in dalam internet ni nanti kalau kita sempat kita boleh. Kalau saya online gini, saja nak tanya, saya boleh buka ke apa internet? Boleh buka juga kak at the same time? Tak. Bolehkah saya buka apa, Google buka and share dengan you all so that lively sikit ni? Boleh kan?
Rasanya boleh kot.
Boleh kan? Nantilah kalau ada masa, nanti dah habis cover topik ni kan. Kalau kita ada time tu bolehlah saya buka tengok ni. Jadi mana after we cover ni, so to look at the real things ni, kita mungkin pergi kepada apa, website berkaitan. Boleh juga kan, maknanya at least kita tahu yang praktikal yang hari ni di mana apa yang saya maksudkan MyIPO semua sekali. And the material I think should be more lagi lah kalau ikut dia punya, because if dia punya ni, this interactivity ni is going to be more apa, it's going to be, future is going to be necessary. Because we talk about the punya worth, the value of the interactivities now is getting more and more. Okay. Alright. Kalau nanti, ini saya tak nak kacau. Kalau kacau nanti tak boleh masuk balik. Okay. Kita guna. Okay. To protect. We know that certain business studio also, they are selling product not only locally but also internationally. So you also to have to protect your apa, IP internationally. Other element. International IP, Intellectual Property Protection. So, if you go globally, exporting firm, they face problem or imitation. Face problems or imitation and counterfeit products. So, the solution for this is what? If you go for, you go globally or internationalizing, so you have to go also to protect your patent at international level. In the global market, how? In fact, each country they have their what we call it patent office, but it's going to be very worrying. Troublesome. Going from one country to another. So instead of going from one country to get protection, if you let's say you export something to Japan, you have to apply patent in Japan. So rather than going that, in the world today, you can do that. You can facilitate your patent in multiple countries only to go to single office. Single office ni mana? Di Geneva lah dia kata. With a single office rather than filing in each separate country. Because when we talk about patent, they have an agreement, ada treaty dia. Patent Corporation Treaty, we over now, kalau kita buka ni nanti mungkin kita tengok 100, mungkin 180 atau 200 pasti ni dah, ni obsolete ni maklumat. Okay, mungkin lah bit over 100 tapi bukan, ramai lagi dah masuk dalam treaty. Maknanya to make sure lah dia punya product. So negara kita pun saya ingat masuk juga dalam ni Patent Corporation Treaty with over. Nanti kita buka lah dia punya apa. Kalau ada masa kita buka Geneva punya itulah, Geneva punya apa, punya website dia, kita tengok kita ni negara yang keberapa dalam ni. Because maksudnya instead of going one country in another to get better punya protection, so just apply, go to the one office ni inilah yang panggil the World Intellectual Property Organization. In short, kita panggil WIPO, WIPO in Geneva, benda tu ni in Amsterdam University. So this instrument help to reduce the cost of multiple patent application by firms operating in the global market. Kalau we go for global market lah, we go for the global markets. Okay. So if we go there, this will indirectly contribute to the economy of the nation because it have to contain imitation and counterfeit product. Maksudnya kalau we go there, maknanya we stay protect. I mean, stay chances that the company will earn income, and of course the income will benefit the country, to prevent from those imitation and counterfeit product. Okay, so WIPO, World Intellectual Property Organization, and we are, kita salah seorang daripada negara lah yang masuk dalam WIPO, World Intellectual Property Organization. Okay, alright. That is the first apa kita baru cakap dah, first type of intellectual property, first key form ataupun first form of intellectual property, which is patent. And the second one ni cuma kita family ni copyright lah, copyright. Okay. So cuma ingatlah, before we go for copyright, ingatlah the basic requirement to obtain a patent, kita dah nampak tadi, kena ada, it has to have be, dia mesti ada apa, must have utility, dia mesti useful, useful untuk ni lah, product you bring, satu benda yang berguna lah, berguna. Dan satu lagi yang dia punya basic requirement for obtaining patent, it must be novel. Novel tu, N-O-V, bukan novel baca buku, bukanlah. Novel ni maknanya dia kata ni, must be different from what has come before. Maknanya yang sebelum dah ada ni, dia mesti different. That's why kalau produk yang you develop ni, mesti different. Telling about the uniqueness, the different from those yang dah existing. Otherwise, untuk nak qualify, untuk pattern pun tak dapat. Okay, satu lagi dia katakan, not obvious, as you mentioned tadi, it must not be obvious to a person of ordinary in the field. Mana orang yang macam biasa, macam saya katakanlah, you buat produk tu, saya pun boleh buat juga. Tak ada kelebihan dia, tak ada different. Jadi, you cannot defend that something, your product is something of your special, something that is different, something not obvious. It must be novel, novel, must be useful, must not be of obvious. Okay. Okay, talk about copyright, another second part. Okay. Copyright, ni kalau bahasa Melayu apa kita panggil? Hak apa? Copyright. Tak apa, hak cipta kan? Hak cipta, Better lah, hak cipta. Dia ada dunia logo with a small italic P. But copyright, as you all know, selalunya dia come up with the word C, small C, kan? Okay? Copyright. Okay. Apa itu copyright? Copyright is a form of intellectual property. Yalah. It's another type of intellectual property, protection. First type, okay, kita tadi kita kata patent. Another form of intellectual property, another type of intellectual protection or exclusive right given to individuals. Individuals, maybe the grant individuals, they give those the individuals, the individuals should be the owner lah. The owner of what, but who produce the original works of art and literature, music, hasil-hasil karya dia lah. Apa hasil-hasil karya dia? Or literature dia, music, film, sounds, sound recording, broadcast, derivative works and computer punya. Ini yang benda-benda yang termasuk dalam apa? Copyright. Okay. So at the end, of course, the idea what? Huh? Apa idea ni dia bagi semua rakyat ni? Of course lah. At the end apa? For the owner tu to obtain dia punya benefit lah. Benefit apa biasanya? Economic benefit lah. To gain apa? Dapat mana copyright. Imagine mana kalau orang nak cannot simply use your copyright. If you want to use, okay. It has a term, maybe you have to pay for it. Nak guna dia punya copyright. Dia copyright. Okay. Okay. Right. Okay, copyright in Malaysia. Copyright pun ada law yang govern dia. Copyright basically is governed by the Copyright Act. Tadi ada copyright patent. Banyak orang nak tunggu. Of course lah, we are not lawyers. Kalau ni mungkin lawyers, they know well lah. But ni act. Saya katakanlah ada patent, not only patent. Ada intellectual property punya lawyer kot. Dia punya yang specialized. So, kita pun ada specialized. Macam dia pun sama juga. Lawyer pun ada specialized. It's not that easy. Eh? So, copyright protection is governed by the Copyright Act 1907. Okay. The different ni, copyright word is protected automatically. Copyright ni lain pula case-nya. It's not necessary for you to apply. Only. When you have the word done, the word is yours. It's, in fact, immediately it's protected automatically and dia protected terus. Tapi syaratnya upon fulfillment of the following condition. Ada syarat dia lah. Sufficient effort has been spent to make the word original in character. Semua dah. You can prove that you have already spent so many time, money, whatever lah. Whatever. That you can prove that that is your original word. Your word. Maknanya kadang-kadang itu kadang-kadang kena simpan juga draft-draft tu. Dan setengah orang yang memang concern kena simpan draft-draft. How long it takes time ambil gambar, whatever lah. Kalau ada tape, orang kata tape jugalah, whatever tu, to prove that is yours. Jadi kalau orang lain ambil, oh I know, this is a plagiat copy, easily can detect nowadays. Orang yang plagiat, copy, apa semua senang, senang. Okay. Satu lagi dia punya condition ya. The word has been written down lah. Kena ada bukti, dia kena tulis lah. Kalau tak tulis, mesti ada bukti dah direkodkan ataupun dah reduce to a material form. Apa dalam bentuk material, whatever lah. Itu maknanya barulah kita boleh claim itu kerja dia. Okay, satu lagi. The author is a qualified person of the word in Malaysia. Katakanlah saya tulis buku. I want to apply for copyright lah. Eh, tak payah apply, maknanya it's my copyright lah. Tapi kena buktikanlah saya qualified. Kalau buku tu mekanikal, sedangkan saya bidang saya entrepreneurship atau finance, that which of course I'm specialized in finance, jadi tak qualified lah. So maknanya I cannot say that is my word. So still not protected lah. Cannot be protected automatically. Jadi maknanya not necessary to go for ni lah. So di Malaysia ni atau di seluruh dunia sebenarnya, a word is protected automatically. Kalau kita fulfill this three condition. Condition dia. Okay. Apa yang, what can copyright protect? Nanti copyright protect apa? Okay, copyright protect literary words. Ini karya-karya lah. Hasil karya-karya. Karya-karya. Ini novel tu lah. Buku-buku novel tu. Ataupun ada contoh je lah. Instruction manuals, computer programs, itu include under what? Under lah karya-karya lah. Ada song, lirik lagu, artikel dan apa sajalah database yang ada. Okay, itu karya-karya ni. Itu that is fall under copyright. Okay. Clear, maknanya that novel, instruction manual ke computer program. So maknanya kita itu hasil orang. Hasil orang lain. Hasil orang lain, that is the copyright of the owner. Okay. Ada juga kerja-kerja apa? Dramatik. Drama-drama macam ada theater presentation, stage shows. Maknanya kita cannot easily. Dia orang punya presentation lah. Mak Yung ada cara dia present. Dia punya ni ada cara punya present. Nari, tarian apa semuanya. Ada dia punya own style. K-pop punya ada style. Itu dramatic word. Dia is dia punya copyright. Musical word yang komposer lagu-lagu lain-lain cara bunyi yang composition ni music. Kalau kata kalau negaraku ada dah ambil orang lain, itu makna kita dah breach of ni lah. Law. Okay, musical words. Artistic word, kerja-kerja yang artistik like buat paintings, itu memang obvious lah. Itu copyright. Painting, so, engraving, okay. Photograph, sculptures kan lain-lain. Sculptures kan banyak dia orang muda. Colleges, architecture punya work, technical drawing, diagrams, maps and logo. Ini under copyright. That's why saya tengah bersih. Kemudian ada juga yang bentuk dalam bentuk apa, layouts or typo graphical arrangement used to publish work for a book. Layout-layout kan ada kan, dia orang buat layout dan sebagainya. Tunjuk ni itu. Recordings. Recording yang ada macam sounds, music, film, jingles, itu. Ataupun broadcast. Kita tengok example dokumentari yang buat live coverage and event. Segera-segera tu live tu dia punya copyright siapa punya. Kita tengok. Kadang dia orang lain ambil ehsan daripada apa RTM1 lah kita tengok. That is dia memang apa tahu the copyright tu belongs to the community. So dalam konteks broadcast tu, dokumentari tu that is a copyright. Boleh diprotect. Derivative words. Ni macam ni lah. Kerja. Maknanya daripada kerja buku dulu, produce. Harry Potter produce buat. Producing Harry Potter movie series from novel. Daripada novel, ada kerja. Itu juga copy. Copyright. Dia ada copyright. Itu what can copyright protect. Itu. Okay. Siapa tu? Tuan punya lah. Who are the owners of the copyright? Bukalah. The owner. Kalau yang kerja-kerja yang literary word, yang kita tahu secara logiknya, literary words. Literary word ni hasil-hasil karya lah. Yang karya seorang tu mungkin termasuk software, database, whatever lah. Buku-buku dan sebagainya. And then theater punya tadi. Theater punya musical or artistic word masuk fotografi ni. The author or the creator of the word is the first owner. Kalau katakanlah literary word, beli buku. Beli buku tu, author or creator of the word is the owner. Author or the creator of the word is the first owner of copyright. In some situation, two or more person may be joint authors. Ada juga kan buku-buku tulis dua authors. Itu dia lah. Biasa logik lah. Okay, kalau you tulis macam, tulis buku ke apa-apa ni. So, you ada. Owner. Okay. Film. Kalau film-film yang ada ni siapa? Copyright ni siapa punya? Okay. The principal director and the film producer are joint authors. And first owners of the copyright. Director dan juga producer. Okay. Promit rights. Okay. Sound recording. The author and the first owner of copyright is the record producer. Okay. Author. And the first owner of the copyright tu kalau sound recording is the record producer. Lagu apa semua saya record producer lah. In the case kalau broadcast, the broadcasters. Macam kat TV3 dia yang buat tu dia broadcast. Orang lain ni dia dapat eksklusif lah. Itu copyright dia. And in the case of published edition, the publisher. Publisher pula. Kalau publish punya edition, publisher. Dia punya penerbit lah. Kalau word, okay. Ada clause di sini kata. If the work is made by an employee in the course of his or her employment. Kalau kita masih bekerja, kita je sebagai employee. So, in the course of his or her employment, unless there is any contrary agreement, the copyright in the work shall be deemed to the person who commissioned the work or the employer. Kalau kita masih bekerja, the copyright in the work shall be deemed to the person who commissioned. Maksudnya kalau dalam di UITM nak kata saya kerja di UITM, saya buat buku dan saya kerja di UITM, tapi copyright sebenarnya dan UITM suruh buat apa-apalah buku ke, jadi dia punya punya copyright itu bilang setiap UITM lah. Itu masuk kalau masih bekerja, kalau masih bekerja. Okay, itu ownership of copyright. Okay, how long copyright will be protected? Okay, generally Copyright subsists during the life of the author plus 50 years after his death. Kita tengok macam lagu-lagu filem Lee apa, apa cerita-cerita movie apa semua ni. Dia punya ni, dia punya protectednya, maximumnya. Itu caranya. Copyright subsist during the life of the author. Lagi author tidur, lagi author tidur dia, dia maknanya author tak adalah kita rasa author tidur, dia masih lagi protected. That means no one can apa, copy. Copy dah senang kita kata. No one can copy. Okay. The life of the plus 50 years after dia mati. Lepas dia mati pun mana is still protected 50 years after his death. Itu kalau ni. However, if the work has not been published. Kalau belum lagi published during lifetime. Kerana setengah orang buat ni dia tak publish. Mungkin faktor macam mana kematian ke immediate. During life or time of the not buying during the lifetime of the author, copyright in the work continue to subsist until the expiration of 50 years. Following the year in which the work was first published. Okay. Kalau in the case of work with joint authorship, the life of the author who dies life is used for the purpose of calculating. Jadi kan setengah buku tu ada apa-apa karya tu, whatever lah yang protected tu. Dia going to dia do that John Lee. Jadi first one umur dah. Saya dah umur ada yang buat second one younger. Then younger tu lama lagi nak mati. So maknanya dia go for the second one. The life author kata who died last is used for the purpose of calculating the copyright duration of the work. Itu protection. Okay, legal. Apa? What are the legal rights of the copyright owners? As the owner of copyright, the owner have the right, exclusive right to what? To control what? Generally lah. Of course, being the owner of the being the owner of the copyright works, the owner have the right, the exclusive right, no, the exclusive right to control apa? Control reproduction. Anybody to hak dia, means as the owner, you have the right to reproduce the works in any form. Sama ada fotokopi ke, rekod ke, whatever lah. So, and of course, you have the right to control the performing, showing or playing to the public. Mana orang lain tak boleh show to public lah kita. Tu kadang kita takut lah kalau orang ambil exercise dia duty ni, kalau orang tahu hak dia. To perform, showing or playing to the duty. Ingat kalau orang tak orang tahu dia punya right, maybe ramai tu kena saman. Kalau kita ambil hak orang tu tu. Because owner, but owner saja only have the right to control ni. To show or to play to the public, to perform. To communicate to the public. To communicate. Yang ni kalau nasib baik kita tak lama benda jadi public. Tapi kalau orang di owner tu serious, want to do, to take action, legal action, they can do. Banyak kan setengah hari ni orang communicate orang punya. Rupanya hak orang lain, copyright words of other person to the public. Tapi nampak general sangatlah hari ni kan. Okay, distribute copies to the public by sale or other transfer ownership. Dia yang boleh. And to commercial, to rent lah, whatever lah, to the public. Maknanya. This exclusive right apply irrespective of whether the works are copied partly or wholly. Tak boleh ambil baru pun tak boleh ni. Tak boleh. Tak boleh. Tak kira kata separuh je. No. Cannot be. Because the owner is still the owner. Okay. And dia ada copyright law. Okay, apa yang dimaksudkan pelanggaran syarat-syarat ni lah? Copyright. What constitute copyright infringement? Okay, apa yang lah? Copyright is infringed. Ini dilanggar lah. When an unauthorized person perform any of the following. Lawan tadi lah. Lawan yang ni. Definitely, ini sebagai tuan punya. That is the right. Of course, against if infringe, if someone lah, other people, other those people not be authorized by the owner, they reproduce. Inilah any other form. They reproduce any material form, perform, exhibit, shows, or play, or distribute to the public. To the public ni. Maksud to the public. Mungkin kalau tak pulang balik, public, kita dalam contact public, okay, buat public. Ini amat us. Okay. Communicates by cable. Ini macam cara not only by cable kan. By internet ke apa. Or broadcast of the whole infringement work or substantial work of the original or derivative work. Mix for sale or hire any infringing copy. Make for sale copy-copy yang ada or hire any infringing copy. Sells, lets for hire or by way of trade exposes or offers for sale or hire any infringing copy. Ataupun satu lagi infringing possesses, ni possess punya, kita memiliki any infringing copy. Tapi dalam konteks individu dia kata otherwise than for its private and domestic view. Kalau kita guna untuk personal tak ada. Misalnya katakanlah material buku kita potestat banyak-banyak itu dah ke infringement. Tapi kalau kita potestat for personal use iaitu otherwise than for private and domestic use, kita sendiri pergi potestat satu. Kalau kena tangkap itu kita kata ni it's not ni, it's for personal use infringement copy. Itu dia bukan, dia dalam konteks law ni dia tak panggil infringement. Yang mana it's not infringement, it's pelanggaran. That's why the possessors otherwise than for its private and domestic use, untuk personal je lah. Imports into Malaysia otherwise than for its private. Untuk Malaysia, untuk private aja you. Any infringement. Saya pun saya suka ni untuk guna personal lah. That's why kalau saya kata saya ada kopi, ibu kan tak berani nak itu. Especially in public ni. Besok kalau dah meluas orang tahu ni, sudahlah. Mungkin kena imagine lah kalau kita ajak satu buku berapa harga, kena su, berat lah. Itulah. Tapi kalau post personal, itu sekarang ni banyak orang kira PM tepi lah, PM tepi, walaupun PM tepi tak boleh digunakan kata. Tapi itu ni lah untuk private use. PM tepi, PM tepi je kan macam hari sekarang ni. Biasa kan buat PM tepi pun semua. Okay. Alright, that is ni, infringement. Okay. Okay, the third types of intellectual property. Tolong ni apa? Trademark. Trademark. Okay. Trademark ni kadang kita panggil apa? Dalam bahasa kita apa? Bahasa Melayu pun panggil trademark. Cak dagang. Cak apa? Cak dagang kan? Cap dagang. Okay, cak dagang. Okay, so apa itu trademark? What is trademark? Trademark ni semua kita tahu dia punya itu is any word. Is any word lah. Any word ataupun name. Nanti in word, any name. Name tu yang distinctive name lah. Name ataupun mark, symbol, motto, identified with the company's product. Indistinctive mana nama yang berbeza lah, asing yang tak sama orang lain. Okay. Trademark is a sign which distinguish the goods and services of one trader from to another. Membezakan. We know that when we have a trademark, of course the trademark is a sign to that is ours, our goods is different. The goods that of ours at the one trader is different from those other traders. That is trademark. So we know that the signs apa? A sign pula juga kata includes words. Sign tu include words. Je kita tengok trademark ada macam-macam kan, ada dalam bentuk words. Nama Honda trademark kan, Nissan ada kata sekarang trademark kita Honda Nissan. Macam-macam nama lah. Sony, whatever ni. Pictures, ada bentuk gambar. Macam proton. Gambar apa? Ada gambar rimau. Ada bentuk logo. Logo dia. Ada bentuk nama. Ada bentuk letters. Ada bentuk numbers. Ada pun untuk combination semua ni. Okay. Trademark ni apa? It's used as a marketing tool to enable customer recognize the product of a particular product. So maknanya kelebihannya tu imak ni, dia provide consumers, consumers to recognize the product, the product of the particular traders. So mana the other way lah. Okay. So maknanya example consumer know, consumer this product belongs to what, to what company. Imagine lah kalau certain there is no treatment, maybe if we want to look for certain product, that is going to be what we call it confusing, confusing for us to look for certain product. So we look through the treatment. Okay. So function, what are the function? Apa dia punya function of the treatment? What are the function of treatment? Kalau ada treatment, one of the functions, function is origin function. What is it? A treatment helps to identify the source and those responsible for the products and services sold in the market. Jadi kita tahulah kalau kita beli apa-apa produk, we know that we the product with the treatment, we know we can find out those source. They mean the original, those who produce the product, whatever the product, and responsible for the products and services in the market. The origin function, we know that they can trace to the origin, meaning to the source. Okay, so another functions of Toma is choice function. So people, when they want to buy product, of course, maybe it's more convenient if they know that they can find out which is a product which is offered their choice. So by having the, what you call it, the trademark, enables consumer to choose goods and services with ease while shopping. Ease of shopping easily. When we are satisfied with certain product or whatever criteria that makes the choice. So having the product, so will help or enable customer to to choose the product with product. That is trademark punya function. Okay. Okay, another function is quality. Consumer choose certain trademark for its own quality. Okay, we are satisfied with certain quality of the product. So and then of course bear in mind lah, if we have a trademark, that means we have to maintain certain quality, and people are satisfied with a certain quality. So they go for the same trademark, and then they expect, of course, the company can deliver the quality required. So in that, of course, trademark play the function as a quality. For the quality. Okay. Another functions of trademark, apa function trademark? It's marketing function. Trademark, kita tengok banyak, trademark plays important role in marketing. It is normal for consumer to make purchases based on continuous influence on advertising. We know that people every day we being bombarded by so many advertisement with a certain trademark. So and then of course that will influence, okay, that will maybe attract us influence us to purchase a product with a trademark. And of course, the last one here, economic function. Established trademark is a valuable asset. Like I said before, money is a trademark is it's already there, good enough for so long. Maybe some of the product, they can sell the product by licensing or through franchise. Yeah, trademark. So the trademark can generate income for the owner. That is a apa function dia? Five functions of treatment: origin function, choice function, quality function, marketing function, and economic function. Okay, treatment. Okay. Alright. Okay. The important. Why you need to register? So the question is, of course, treatment you have to register. Apply for it. So the idea of applying for trademark, of course, is different with the copyright. Copyright importance of trademark. Trademark provide what? Like other IP, of course, trademark provide exclusive rights, and of course, trademark provide legal evidence. Okay, so having a trademark, trademark owners comfort the rights, the exclusive right to use their mark in trade. Yeah, so kalau dah you have the what, you have the IP, intellectual property of trademark, so you have the rights, exclusive right to use your marks in trade. Okay, they also have the right to take legal action against infringe, for legal action for infringement under Trade Act 1976 against others who use their marks without consent. Tengok nama-nama itu hari pun berlaku. People use macam McDonald pun kalah dengan apa, Mac apa namanya? Mac apa dulu, Mac Curry ke apa? McDonald thought this Mac Curry belong to them, but of course under the law, when they go fight, what is the punya Mac Curry, not the McDonald punya rights, trademark punya right. Jadi dia kena kalah, dia kena bayar. So we cannot take for granted because others have the right. Okay, they can also lodge complaint to enforcement division of ministry for appropriate action. The ministry, to if there is someone use illegally, illegal use of the IP, IP that's what trademark the IP. Okay, trademark also provide legal evidence. So when you register, okay, importantly, issue certificate will be issued by the registrar of trademark under the ministry. Okay, that is can be used as a prima facie evidence. Be the owner of the trademark. Certificate of registration serves an important document to establish the ownership of goods exported to other country. Boleh digunakan lah. Why it is important for you to register to trademark. Itu kelebihan dia lah. Right. So the law that govern the trademark, masing-masing ada law dia tadi. Patent ada law dia, dia punya copyright pun ada law dia, trademark pun ada law dia in Malaysia. Okay, in Malaysia, trademark is governed by Trademark Act 1976 and Trademark Regulation 1970 Amendment 2001. The law. Okay. Registration of trademark in Malaysia, it's not compulsory. Tak compulsory ni ya. Register is not compulsory. Unregistered trademark may still obtain protection under common law. Kalaupun kita ada, we come up with our own trademark but we did not register, it's okay dia kata sini. Kalau tak register, it's okay. Can we still get protection or not? Dia kata still get protection. Tapi not under ni lah. Not under different law, but it's under common law. Common law by virtue of use and reputation. Mana orang guna ada law, undang-undang ni lah, undang-undang biasa ni lah, common law by virtue of use and reputation. Ni lawyer punya kerja lah. Dia tengok kat mana ruang dia nak menang kes ni. Tak ada law yang ni. But tak register. Kalau tak register, kalau register maybe straight away maybe fall under this law lah. Ada Trademark Act, tapi kalau tak register masih lagi still be protected, tapi tak kerja lawyer lah tu. Dia masih dalam undang-undang common law dia panggil, by virtue of use and reputation. Thus taking action against infringer can still be applied, boleh buat juga walaupun tak register. But the register of trademark is not compulsory in Malaysia. Walau macam mana dia kata, kalau tak register dia kata, however, protection through usage is difficult and tedious. Susah lah. Dia kata nak proof. Protection through usage is difficult and tedious, very tedious. So, the original statement owner must convince the court that the infringing act mislead the public. Mungkin dia bawa kes ni, atas kes ni kalau menang ni, the register ni boleh convince that the act tu mislead the public. Satu, menang kes ni. Dua, the infringing goods and services may be mistaken for their own goods and services. Jadi itu. Atas dasar ni maknanya nak prove ni is not that easy. Tapi still under protection the common law. Walaupun tak register. Okay. Not our trademark registry. talking about registration of trademark. Not all trademarks can be registered. Ha, dia kata. Yang trademark can be registered, dia mesti ada elemen ni. For registered, for you to register trademark. Trademark for goods and services must be distinctive. Ha, itu mesti pasti. Ha, trademark for goods ni. Must be distinctive and may take the following terms. Ha, ada yang ni lah. Ada yang pakai nama je, invented words or words. Ada yang pakai applicant signature. Dia kata. Words with no direct relation to goods or services. Geographical, no direction to goods or no direct, no relation to geographical name or surname. Any distinctive sign, such as logo, ada juga. Trademark dia come up with something dengan logo, dengan picture, symbol, etc. Not deceptive lah. Trademark yang deceptive tak boleh. Ini yang menipu lah. Confusing atau contrary the law atau scandalous or offensive. Tak boleh register. Memang mungkin reject lah tu. And not identical or similar to earlier registered trademark. Kalau dah ada dulu, earlier orang dah buat confusing. Deming tak boleh lah tu. Tak boleh register. And not identical or similar to the well-known trademark. So that is apa ni yang trademark that, apa yang boleh diregister. So yang tak boleh register ni beside lah. Yang identical tak boleh lah. Yang identical, yang deceptive, yang confusing, contrary, scandalous semua tak boleh. Yang tak unik, yang distinctive, yang apa, yang biasa-biasa je lah tu tak ya. Okay. Yang word yang ada relationship no direct relation word that we know direct relation to good, tapi yang ada direct relation to good mungkin tak boleh dan sebagainya. So word tu ambil word orang lain, tak invent word tu, tak boleh jual. Okay. A trademark, registered trademark. Okay. A trademark cannot be registered if, kalau dalam Malaysia lah, it contains or represents prohibited under Trademark Act 1976. Apa dia? Dia kata kalau trademark regulation, such as what? Kalau kita guna pakai patent, such as what? Patent patented by royal letters, patent registered identity. Kalau kita guna nama agung-agung ke, nama royal-royal ke, nama army ke, maknanya guna-guna diraja-diraja semua tu, red cross and dan nama-nama itulah yang famous. Ataupun kita guna words or representative or ASEAN or national or whatever lah. Sebenarnya tak boleh tu. Tak guna, boleh. Cannot be registered. You contain words yang ada unsur-unsur ni lah. Yang melibatkan apa. Logik lah. Guna tentera kan semua sekali tak boleh. Yang tu exclusive for them. Yang exclusive for them. Okay. Sesuatu yang sudah trademark kita nampak bagus tapi kita register tak boleh. Trademark register in Malaysia are not protected abroad. Trademark yang kita register in Malaysia are not protected. Sama macam tadi, kalau we want to protect trademark overseas, so it is necessary to apply register abroad separately. Kita boleh apply separately to the country that we want to do business. Tapi macam tadi juga lah. Kalau nak minimize, of course we can go to the one center to WIPO lah. Sudah. WIPO tadi. World Intellectual Property punya organisation di Geneva. The protection of trademark is required. Obviously, it is necessary to apply for example abroad separately. Okay. Ini application call ni mungkin kita tengok lah. Mungkin dah berubah kot hari ni. Kalau ikut proses dia, every application will be examined to ensure registrability. To apply to my IPO tadi lah. Perbadanan Harta Intellect Malaysia tadi. Ataupun Intellectual Property Corporation of Malaysia. If there are any objection to registration of a particular trademark, the applicant may apply for hearing. Kalau ada objection, you want to apply for trademark, you applicant may hearing. Trademarks accepted will be advertised in the government gazette. Ada warta, kerajaan. Kalau you buka lah internet pun ada kerajaan. Tapi jangan orang buka lah warta kerajaan tu. Tapi prosedur. jadi apa, diterima, dia akan betah. Orang yang berkenaan, apa dia akan apa, yang interested tu, yang parti apalah, apa dia akan make copy kan, simpan copy tu, government gazette. If no opposition, the trademark will be registered. Registered certificate will be issued. Selanjutnya application. Sekarang ni mungkin berubah kot. Application fee berapa, ada amount, dia tak tahulah berapa sekarang ni. Advertisement in government gazette and issued ada certain amount. Dia boleh check lah kan ni. Saya tak suka ni lah. Sebab selalu figure-figure ni berubah. Ha? Tadi boleh address pun dah berubah. Okay? Okay? Berapa lama trademark kalau kita apa? It will be protected. Dah ada trademark. Trademark will be valid only for 10 years from the date application. Tapi jangan pandang lah. Kata trademark ni. Jadi kita boleh tengok apa yang ada sekarang. Trademark sekarang ni dia keep on renewing. Dia boleh renew. Maknanya lepas nak expire, dia akan renew lagi. 10 years, 10 years. Kalau 100 tahun, maknanya dah 10 kali renew lah. Trademark. Valid for 10 years from the application and may be renewed every 10 years. So dia kena renew. Yang trademark yang kita tahu Petronas. Jadi renew selalu. Petronas, McDonald's ada trademark apa lagi. Banyak macam trademark yang ada. Even apa. Dia punya apa. Mungkin JDT pun lah. Trademark juga kot. Liga punya tu pun. Semua trademark. Not, orang lain tak boleh copy lah. Tapi dia boleh lah. Dia protection 10 years juga. Tapi dia dia kena keep on renewing lah after every 10 years. Okay. Dah 12 sekejap. Kita sebelum move to another. Kita berehat sekejap boleh tak? Boleh tak kita berehat sekejap? Hello? Banyak juga.
Boleh, sir.
Kita berehat. Kita
okay, sir.
Kita 12. 12:10 lah. Ha? 10 minit. Ha?
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
Okay, kita rehat sekejap. Dah bagaimana ni, ha? Kita rehat sekejap je.
Minum kopi, sir.
Boleh lah. Minum kopi. Kopi dua lah. Saya kena itulah minum air lah. Sikit kot. Thank you.
我想要你可以帮我 print 什么了，帮我 print 一个 3D printer 出来。
Okay lah. Dia boleh start balik lah. Back our class today. Okay, semua dah ready. Boleh start balik lah. Dia boleh mula balik. Okay. Hello. Masuk mini kopi lagi lah.
Boleh sih, boleh.
Dah ready lah. Okay lah. Alright, so okay, last two topic about the key forms, different types of IP that we are supposed to discuss. So satu lagi they call it industrial design. Industrial design. Okay, design as we know, of course, is the ornamental or aesthetic aspect on article. So the design dia kata can consist or may consist of 3D, yeah, 3D features. 3D features such as the shape, the configuration of an article, or 2D features such as pattern and or ornamentation. Ornamentation ialah ornament ni benda yang hiasan kan. Kalau ornamental plants tu, plant yang hiasan kan. Kalau ornamental plant, saya pernah pergi kilang yang buat ornamental plant di Filipina dulu. Cantik yang buat. So, of course, they already come up with a design lah. They mesti ada design for that. So, the design feature must be applied to an article by industrial process or means of which features in your finished article appeal to eye. Okay, that is the design, industrial design. Like others, of course, siapa yang ada right. Register industrial design provides an exclusive right to make. Register ni sama, that means when they are approved lah. Their design, the right to make, import or sell, hire out an article to which design has been applied. Tengah-tengah come up with design, that's why hari ni design thinking. It's a product design also very important. Even certain product now today, banyak produk-produk yang dibuat di US hari ini, mereka dia come up with industrial design yang actual manufacturer-nya dibuat di outsource, they go to China. That's why banyak produk tu made in China. Tapi kalau kita talk about the design, the design itself can be protected, Kita tengok banyak design ini. Okay. So the owner of the registered design has the right to take legal action against an infringer. Yang melanggar tu, yang ambil hak dia tu. Within 5 years from the act of infringement. Ialah kalau kita buat design, tiba-tiba orang curi kan. So design tu, so within 5 years from the act of infringement. So kalau after 5 years, tak valid lah. So that's why action must be taken very fast within 5 years of your hasil, of your design. Okay, design tu, what is registrable is the design. And industrial design must be new at the date of application. New. Macam yang tadi juga copyright apa, pattern. Mesti be new at the date of application. Maksud new apa sini? A design is new if it has not been made available or disclosed to the public in any way. In any way, or any means lah. Whatsoever in Malaysia before filing date. Kalau dah apply, not qualified for industrial design punya right, IP. So dangerous juga kalau kita design je nanti kita ni. Tapi academic, apalah kan academic, whatever it is. Tapi, maknanya you have the right. You have the right to design. Okay, that is industrial design. Okay, what sort of design is excluded for registration? Apa eh? Design is not registrable if it does not have a clear aesthetic appearance. Aesthetic punya appearance lah. Tak ada dia punya lah. Yang menarik kan. Tak ada word lah. Mana design must be something aesthetic. Something simple yang biasa ni. That is not clear, very vague, ambiguous. I think that should be. Design is not registrable if it is method or principle of construction. Tak masuk dalam itu lah design. If design features detected solely by function, tak boleh juga. Ini yang tak masuklah eksklusif, yang tak termasuk dalam stock design that can be registered. Integral parts which consist of features that dependent upon the appearance of another article. Differs only in immaterialities or in features commonly used in the relevant trade. The design those are contrary to the public or morality. Adalah design yang pelik-pelik yang bercanggah dengan public ataupun immoral, tak boleh, takkan di registerkan, okay. Atau apa lah for registration. Okay, filing of industrial design, macam mana nak apply lah, application of it lah. As claim are based on first to file rule basis. So, filing of industrial design should be made at the earliest possible time before time or before an article is disclosed to the public. Sebelum artikel, you can really have to file. Kalau you disclose, then prior disclosure will destroy the novelty. Tak adalah originality, tak adalah. Tak ada differences, tak ada differentiation. Yeah, the uniformity of design. Therefore, extreme care should be exercised to ensure secrecy of the design. Design is very, very important. Yeah? So how long? Just a design. Once you get the right, be protected. Okay, a registered investment is given an initial protection of 5 years from the day of filing of application, and is extendable for further 2 consecutive terms of 5 years. Maknanya protected for 15 years. Kalau kita renew. One 5 years after almost, then we extend another 5 years and we can go up to maximum of 15 years. Okay. So the measure macam mana? How extensive industry protection? Industrial design registered in Malaysia is only protected in Malaysia. In order to protect in other countries, so application will have to be filed within 6 months from the earliest date when it was first filed in other, mana kalau dah file kat sini. So you have to file it again, dengan other countries, other countries. Itu industrial design. Who can apply? Siapa yang boleh apply for design registration? Only the owner of the design may apply. Owner of design may apply to register design through agent. Though agent can be authorized to make application. Mungkin kita engage consultant juga, agent to apply for design. Yang orang tak nak buat kan, kadang benda tu tedious, terlambat to apply the agent to make application. Where an applicant's ordinary resident or principal place business is outside Malaysia, the applicant shall appoint an agent registered in the Registrar of Industrial Design Agent. Okay. All application for the registration of ID industrial design must be lodged at the Industrial Design Property Corporation Malaysia lah. Perbadanan Harta Intelek Malaysia. So ini ada dia punya unit dia tu di sana, bahagian pendaftaran industrial design. Nah, itulah setakat yang maklumat yang ada ni. Tapi saya tak tahu lah, kalau kita buka website dia mungkin ada perubahan, I don't know. So setakat yang ada ni, inilah. Tapi dia ada lain jenis ni, dia is industrial design. Tapi kalau di US dia tak ambil ni, mungkin dia masuk dalam pattern dan design ni. Dia masuk dalam pattern, macam-macam cara lah kat certain country. Okay, the last IP, the last intellectual property that we're going to talk today is what, trade secrets. So trade secret is the one dikatakan the last ni. What is trade secret? Apa yang dikatakan trade secret ni? Okay. So trade secret, what do you mean by trade secret? Is any formula? So we know that today dia kata information very powerful for make the business successful. So if people use your information for good information lah. I mean, the chances they can be more successful, then they can overtake you, or they mean they have a competitive advantage. So, maknanya, when we talk to secret that need to be present, Okay, we know that, okay, information very is critical to the success of any business. But information, kalau kita tengok, tak ada, does not qualify for patent. Ada information does not qualify for patent. Kalau qualify for patent, straight away go for patent lah. Ada information does not qualify for trademark, copyright or industrial design person. So confidentiality means that business need to keep secret to help maintain. So in other words, in order for you, we know that information is so important and very critical to the business success, and you need to keep it secret. In order to do that, so you have to apply for trade secret. So in other words, you want to retain the confidentiality of information to make your business more competitive. Dengan orang dia ada kelebihan saing kenapa? Kerana dia have a competitive advantage. Kelebihan saya, dia have a competitive advantage. So, what are those trade secret yang saya kita masukkan? Or what is trade secret? Any formula. Trade secret is apa? Is any formula. Okay, it can be apa? It can be patent, any physical device. But any idea, process or other information that provides the owner or the patient with a competitive advantage ni macam mana? Ha, itu keyword ni mana? Semua owner tu mesti ada apa? Competitive advantage. Ha, ada. Maknanya with that makes you more apa? Ada more advantage lah. You have more, ada kelebihan bersaing di pasaran. Ha, in fact, kalau maknanya kalau other people access or get your information, information that mean their chances they can be, yeah, they can be or they can be more successful than your company. Secret. Okay. What are those characteristics of information that can be classified as being? Apa yang criteria information that can be classified as what? As what qualified for trade secret protection? Apa yang boleh qualified as a trade protection? Not all information qualified for trade secret protection. So in general, yeah. Okay, information that is yang boleh qualified, that is not known outside the company. The information that is not known. Kalau those information is known to the company, it's not worth protecting lah. Not known outside the company, okay. Oh, satu lagi mana? Information that is not only inside the company on a need to know basis. Tahu inside the company people know it, but of course known need to on the basis of need lah. Ada keperluan, maybe on the ada tujuan dia, tugas dia lah. Okay. Information that is safeguarded by stringent efforts to keep the information confidential. Mana? The information in such way that safeguarded by stringent efforts to keep the information confidential. Mesti ada element that you try your best to protect from being apa? Being exposed lah. Exposed to others. And information that is valuable and provide the company a compelling competitive advantage. Maknanya information yang ada ni that should be selected mestilah sesuatu yang apa valuable and that provide the company a compelling competitive advantage. Information tu is worth protecting, dia very important for you as a competitive advantage. And information that you develop itu dah already be developed at a great cost, time and effort. So, yeah, it's not simply just overnight, you know, but there's a proof that you definitely is your effort, your brainstorming, whatever the idea of such good, and add a great amount of money spent on it, and a length period of time that you spend on it. So, and pastikan juga that information cannot be easily duplicated, reverse engineered or discovered. Kalau senang boleh duplicate, mana? It's not worth to protect. Easily people can duplicate kalau ni. Walaupun kita nampak macam kata trade secret yang protect buat apa? KFC atau Coca-Cola buat air. nampak mudah tapi cannot easily be duplicated or reverse engineered or discovered by others. Encash can last longer than the term of patent. Secret ni boleh last longer. Kadang patent ni tak lama because patent ni buat invention tak lama. Easily orang ni. Tapi make sure dia kata last longer than the term of patent. Okay. Itu trade secrets. Itu trade secrets. Okay. So, how to protect ni? You need to protect. Kita trade secret protection methods. Ada beberapa cara. How to protect, there are two methods. In general, kita ingat ada dua. Company protect trade secret through physical measures, physical methods ataupun written agreement. Ada dua cara nak protect trade secrets. Okay. So, bagi apa? Kenapa kita protect dia? Dia kata aggressive protection of trade secrets is necessary to prevent intentionally or unintentionally disclosure. Jadi we have to protect it. Okay, to keep it secret, to keep it trade secret. So how to protect it? There are two methods. Yeah, one is to physical methods. Physical methods. This is our to protect. Yeah, okay. This is the one. This is example. Yeah, lah, two method. How they protect? Okay. Example of commonly used physical measures for protecting trade secret. One, when they protect? Tengah company they protect by what? Many companies protect through what? Restricting access. Many companies physical access is they restrict physical access. Dan dalam ni tak semua orang boleh access to certain confidential document. Certain personnel also only can access to certain yang itu to protect trade secret. Okay, labeling document. Those sensitive document should be stamp label. Setengah-setengah kita tengok dalam cerita-cerita. Kalau yang apa, your combination tu dia confidential document stamp dengan private and combination and even restricted. Or maybe secret, dia tulis secret. Secret. Tak boleh orang access lah. Itu cara lah, protect. Ada juga dia kata guna apa? Password protection for competition. Itu juga cara nak protect. Providing employee with clearance to view confidential information by using secure password. Ini biasa kita biasa kalau nak masuk dalam kita punya file, not everybody dia must have password. We look about the secret, our secret. Okay, ada juga dia kata maintaining logbooks. Maintaining logbook for visitors. Kalau nak pergi kan, kalau setengah tempat dia protect trade secrets. Kalau trade UITM ni lah, habis apa? Bukan trade secret, tapi kalau benda yang secret lah, itu bukan trade secret. Exam paper ni, dia ada bilik-bilik khas, bilik kebal. Ataupun nak masuk pula tu, kalau ada visitors ataupun ada lecturer kena masuk, kena isi logbooks for visitors and access to confidential material. Kena ada logbook for access. Many companies maintain logbook for sensitive material and make the employees check out and check in. Kemudian yang ada lagi contoh ni, to protect trade secret, adequate overall security measures. Okay, maintaining lah. Dia maintain adequate overall security measures. Terus apa? Check lockdown, ada guna apa? Ada guna alarm, security personnel. To protect premise. Itu yang satu. Itu cara apa? Cara how you going to protect the trade secret. Okay, itu mesti ada tu lah. Otherwise mungkin kalau cara ni you do not qualified lah. Kalau tak ada cara, you do not qualified to protect to apply for trade secret. Satu lagi through agreement. Ini ada agreement. Banyak company dia gunakan apa? Written agreement juga to protect semuanya to script. New employee biasanya kalau you kerja dalam organisasi, dia ask employee to sign a confidentiality ataupun dipanggil NDA, non-disclosure agreement. If they then tell anyone about it, this is a breach of confidence. So breach of lah, agreement lah, that you can take legal action. That's why banyak company, especially yang company-company software tu, dia lalui lah, kena sign NDA. Jadi you cannot disclose whatever secret they have in the company. Kalau keluar disclose, bahayanya you, kalau dia take legal action, orang tu, employee tu kena, kalau kena court decide, kena bayar, lagi tu lah. Ini dia punya cara nak, dia orang protect trade secret. Itu, yang itulah yang berlaku lah. Inilah pula data-data yang kita ni, yang kita lihat ni, my pool. So cuma ni lah kalau saya nak cuba kan, nak cuba sudah habis dia punya tentang apa, dia punya ni. So, apa isi-isi yang ada lah ni, saya rasa banyak. Kalau you develop product for patent, even the product you develop tu, sebenarnya dia punya apa, apa yang kita bincang hari ni, I think it help also you lah. Whenever you want to talk about your product, make sure the product yang you want to produce or to innovate, whatever, ambil kira element-element of intellectual property, criteria, whatever yang kita bincang hari ni. Supaya maknanya kita buat apa ni sekaligus ambil kira semua faktor. Faktor termasuk lah, protection lah, termasuk apa? Protection, because the value of everything is apa? Okay. Ni cuba kita pergi kerja ni, nanti saya cuba pergi ke ni, nak try testing tu. You don't mind, saya try pergi kepada apa, internet dulu, buka. Yang ni saya tutup, tak ada apa-apa kan tentang ni, no more, finish lah. Saya akan share dia punya handout ni. Ini we have finished already about talking about apa, intellectual property. So, okay, now kita ni lah, kita try pergi kepada ini. Sekejap ya. Macam mana ini. Macam mana nak pergi ni? Saya dah cuba. Macam mana? Saya dah buka, Google ni tapi tak dapat buka. Ya. Allah, macam mana nak buka? Ada nampak tak Google saya? Tak nampak lah. Nampak tak Google saya? Tak ada? Hello?
Tak nampak.
Tak nampak. Macam mana nak share? Tak nampak macam mana? Nak, sebab saya pun nak pergi supaya saya buat ni boleh semua nampak. Everybody can see that I can go to the relevant menu to next time. Bagus juga kalau boleh buka. Dia kena pergi ke. Okay. Kerana saya dah buka Google. Okay, tanya kat you punya new generation ni memang pandai benda gini. Okay. Saya pergi ke sini kat present now ke juga? Sama ke present now eh?
Haa, saya present now juga.
Present now, okay. Lepas tu kena window juga kah? Ke entire screen?
Window.
Window, saya pergi ke window. Tak keluar. Dia tak ada, share benda ni. Ya? Yeah. Ada tak? Cuba tengok. Macam
tu. Boleh, saya.
Boleh? Ah. Oi. Saya cuma tak berani nak buka je. Okey. Boleh eh? Okey, kalau boleh. Mana dia punya ni? Google. Eh, tak keluar pula. Ya. Ah, ni boleh ni, nampak?
Boleh, nampak, nampak.
Ah, nampak. Okey. Okey, first saya tak talk about apa? Dia punya ahli dalam white book. Kenapa kita salah salah seorang kalau kita talk about dia punya tadi kan saya mention about white book. We go to the white book Geneva punya. Sekarang kita fly to Geneva eh. Boleh eh? Kita fly to Geneva kan eh? Ha? Okey eh?
Tak boleh,
kita,
boleh.
Kita belajar kita fly to Geneva. Okey, Geneva ni World International. You nampak eh? World International Property Organization. You dah tahu before ni? Belum lagi kan? You know before ni? Belum kan? Okay, this organization that kita kata tadi, instead of pergi one country to another, you can apply through this WIPO ni. And, okay. Kenapa gini? Kita salah satu negara masuk dalam 50. Okay, kita nampak dia punya ahli. Mana ahli? Wait, begini. Dia punya ni. Happy, wait. Buat WIPO. What is WIPO? Okay. Dia punya IP. IP Academy Patent. Ah, ni dia punya intellectual yang ni. Sana. Dia mention about copyright, patent, trademark, industry design, geography. Ah, dia tambahlah geographical indication satu lagi lah. Tapi about dia punya members. Eh. Dia punya dalam group member ni. Trademark, patent. Ah, industry design. Ah, okay, eh. Kita punya ahli. Hmm. Biar country, biar okay. Country. Ya, yeah, kita punya ahli kita. Members. Members. Ah, members. 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 Members members of member for copyright dia dan entity. Wait, ini dia punya ni. Member of patent. Ni. Okey. Dia punya ni. Okey. Ni country-country ni eh. Bukan ni body ni. Itu bukan eh. Dia buat apa pun eh. Romania. Dia bukan 42. Total Contracting Party. Patent Law Treaty. Dia punya US. Malaysia dia tak. Malaysia tak ada. Eh, Malaysia tak ada. Dia ada juga ni. Dia punya menu dah. Termark sikit. Saya tak jumpa lagi. Dia ada version baru. Tak apalah. Itu maknanya kalau you can go ni. Eh. Of course lah dia punya. Kalau nak baca tentang. Dia punya apa. Kalau saya buka. Pernah buka dulu. Dalam ni. Berapa banyak. You can specialize. Bidang ni satu bidang yang luas lah. Even. Kalau. Zaman tak boleh. Tak boleh kerja ni. Kalau ada opportunity kerjanya. Dia pun bagus lah. Kalau di Malaysia ni. Dengan dalam. Apa. Dalam my Apple ni kena bidang kita kan mana kita expose more to the area ni about intellectual property ni memang useful, a lot useful. In fact kalau yang nama-nama you want to detect to find out the product, Serim pun ada. Serim a lot so we can find out about the patents on banyak. Okay, kalau di Malaysia okay tak apalah, kita forget this. My Apple ni mana you can apply tadi ni. Mana WIPO ni? Mana pula? Okay. Ni WIPO. We go to the ni lah. Kalau di Malaysia, I mentioned to you. Agency involved. Apa dia cakap kita ni tu? Agency involved. My, wait, kan nak keluar. ni my dia kali world my WI pun lagi Malaysia Malaysia ikut ni nak bersamban kali tu kan. My IPO, my IPO agency involved my I so this is this my IPO ni ni punya logo je. Founded in 2003 baru je 2003 sebenarnya. Google wants to be apa? Okay, my IPO ah. Oh dia panggil national saja. Okay, my IPO. Kita buka dia punya ni. Semua boleh boleh nampak tak dia punya ni? Boleh eh? Everybody can see eh?
Boleh.
Okay. So maknanya specialized topic various agency involved in this ni ini yang ada authority. Nama agency apa dia? Intellectual, dipakai logo juga ni. Ini trademark dia lah ni. Intellectual Property Corporation of Malaysia, my IPO. Nampak ah? Dia punya ni and service given dia ni dia highlightkan ni patent, trademark, industrial design, copyright. Oh, cuma ditambah ni geographic indication, IC layout decision, macam dia lah. Kalau trademark ni sini lah. Ha, kalau nak understand ni. So applying ni dia ada di Malaysia ada applying for patent and utility innovation. Ingat ni ya. Applying. So kita ada tengok kalau kita nak search patent and phone fees berapa nak bayar. Ada act dia. Easily kita find act dia. Ada borang, ada kalau patent berapa amount. Okay. Terus ke internet. You punya internet okey tak? Eh? Okey kot internet. Ni ada fees dia. Oh ni fees tadi. Aku cakap ada fees, different fees kan ni. Kalau e-filing apa ya, nak grant for apa request for grant patent 260 for every additional claim 20 entering national phase 20 request for reinstatement 350 per month request for subsequent examination tu banyak cost lah involved request for expedite nak kalau nak expedite examination 2000 nak expedite approval okey kemudian apa lagi macam-macam cost nak impor. So kalau kita tengok ni banyaklah cost impor. Ini dia punya ni berkaitan dengan patent. Kalau berkaitan dengan cat dagang apa trademark. Trademark not necessary kan patent hak cipta apa. Hak cipta apa? Copyright cat dagang trademark ni trademark. Trademark permohonan jadi saya. So the detail about the topic yang kita discuss ni bagi saya lah kan the expert is of course always ni lah dia punya apa dia goes to the agency ni lah agency kita expose lebih gua lah tapi maknanya this area ni dia punya bidang ni memang satu bidang yang kita boleh explore juga sebenarnya banyak benda juga lah we can detect ni dia punya ni permohonan cak dagang ada permohonan dia pendaftaran ada dia punya prosedur dia okay so nampak ah kita ada satu WIPO dengan IPO IPO okay yang tu satu lagi apa yang ni saya satu lagi saya nak share kalau ini betul tak buat ni satu lagi nak share dia punya ni dia punya ni ya sekejap ya. Ada. So kalau kalau kita tengok tadi, apa lagi dia punya ni lah, dia punya apa, whatever it is, saya semua nampak reti, maknanya you have to go to this Perbadanan Hakik Intelek Malaysia lah to get information with regards to intellectual property. So this agency is a agency yang specialized talking about ni. Sebab dia tambah sini, dia ada, dia punya apa, dia ada lagi dipanggil yang kita tak bincang, reka bentuk pun ni ada. We discuss about pattern, cadangan, industrial design, hak cipta. Oh, trade secret tak masuk sini. Kalau di trade secret di US memang, ataupun di WIPO tadi memang ada famous. Mungkin ada kot, dia tak ada petunjuk, petunjuk geografi ni lain. Petunjuk geografi apa pula ada yang masuk kat sini? Petunjuk geografi adalah tanda yang digunakan kat suatu produk kerana produk tersebut mempunyai kualiti dan reputasi yang boleh dikaitkan dengan kawasan berkenaan. Itu lain tu saya. Okay, so okay, before we end this session, I think session ni pun kita ada ada input-input kan, ada input-input berguna lah. That is related to apa? To the new product, to the new product that you, new product atau service yang you develop. Kalau talk about story ya, kalau saya nak cerita share story, nak promi lah. Kalau di, ada satu buku saya baca, macam mana dia combine, eh? Macam mana dia combine orders. Ni company, ni company lama dipanggil. I think tak apalah, kita bukan saya nak ambil ni, content ni how dia combine. Pernah dengar tak company Switchboard Incorporation? Hello? Pernah dengar company Switchboard Incorporation?
Tak pernah saya.
Tak pernah dengar. Okay, Switchboard Corporation ni, ni di US lah. Okay. Switchboard Compression ni dia apa lah, dia company dia founded in 1995, lama. Switchboard is an internet based company. Dia provide online directory services, lama lah internet kan, tapi dia, dia dah early lagi. For free, a user can go to website dia and search online directory over 100 apa berapa million, banyak lah million, and email. Nak cari email, nak cari dia punya apa contact, you can go to website. In addition, site Switchboard ni apa dia kata, offer access to maps, driving direction, even online yellow pages. Yellow pages pernah dengar, yellow pages eh? And city guides for major city di US, pasal tu lah. Essentially, Switchboard connects people. Dia hubungkan orang, consumer with businesses. Businesses mana C to B, it's not this. Mana consumers with businesses mana C to B. C2B, B to B, business to businesses and so forth. When it was launched in 1996, takes 1 year juga kan nak launch. Okay, kerana takes some time. Lalu maknanya to be realistic, kalau you start business, okay, at least bagi time lah 1 year. Switchboard was an internet pioneer. Dia pioneer internet, ya. Yeah. It was the first site to offer free service, free access to telephone numbers and addresses nationwide. Apa yang dia buat? So the key point saya nak cerita sini tentang intellectual property lah. Apa yang dia buat? Soon after successful debut, mula-mula on its white pages, Switchboard added, they add product line dia, dia punya diversify to website and easy to use yellow pages. Campur lagi. This survey enabled the company to start generating income by selling traditional bricks and mortar businesses advertising. Dulu orang bagi jual advertising cara biasa gini lah kan, online dia dah start dah dulu. 1996, lama dah. Switchboard knew from the start that if it was successful, kalau cara dia punya, cara business dia successful, dia kata competitors would try to imitate. Ha, biasalah dalam business ni. Walaupun dia pioneer, tapi kalau dia tak protect, dia kata early cara dia business ni, competitor would try to imitate his business. Apa yang dia buat? Dia kata, because of this company, company buat decision apa dia? Company buat decision, dia kata, the company has aggressively used intellectual property law, guna original principle, to protect the unique aspect of its business. Dia guna macam mana cikguna? For example, apa yang dibuat, dia kata, Switchboard has several patent. Dia ada banyak patent. masuk salah pattern dia tu including one protecting website ability to display search result. Ada satu pattern. And in the well akan dibuat pattern untuk ni lah. Dia punya website punya display. Lepas tu pattern, daripada pattern ni apa dia? Prevent other website managing search fashion exactly macam dia buat. Okay, apa lagi dia buat? To maintain pula exclusive right to the name or its reason, dia pun guna logo lah. Biasalah. Dia guna logo, trademark dia. Apa trademark dia? Dia adalah trademark nombor dia. Switchboard, Maps on Earth, Mac. Semua dia trademark dia. Itu dia register. Semua all registered. Trademark pula. Tadi pattern dah ada. Trademark apa yang kita buat. So maknanya kalau dia ada trademark, this mean no other company can use this name. Nama dia Switchboard. Tak boleh. Dia ada trademark. Dah dua dah. Daripada tu. Finally, apa dia kata? The company protect its written material with copyright. Ha, dia ada protect pula material dia, copyright, see copyright. And of course, owns a number of internet domain name described its services. Okay. Ada lagi cara dia protect pula. Ha, trade secret saja. In addition, all Switchboard employees have signed apa dia panggil? NDA tadi saya kata. Non-disclosure agreement. Semua kena sign agreement. Company employee cannot legally divulge trade secret. Ha, dia ada code, dia protect juga trade secret tadi. Jadi semua kena sign. Semua pekerja kena sign apa? NDA. Apa kita panggil? NDA kan? Non-disclosure agreement. Maksudnya agreement tak boleh disclose. Kalau disclose, sama lah. Tindakan undang-undang. Okay. So kalau kita tengok sini, apa yang berlaku, mana Switchboard ni, dia combine. Dia guna apa? Patents, trademark, copyrights, and trade secret to protect its intellectual property. Kerana that is very critical to punya sector. Jadi hari ni mana dia still, kalau ikut kata ni lah dia. But now there are over 40 major website offering online. Dia banyak lah, beribu-beribu sekarang ni. There are now over 40 major website offering online directory services. Each of these sites compete with Switchboard in one of more. Several of these sites are owned by heavyweight like Yahoo, America Online, Amazon. However, apa yang key point, apabila dia ada intellectual property jadi protect. However, because of Switchboard diligent in the area of IP, intellectual property protection, none of this computer can match what Switchboard has done in several key areas. Switchboard see these unique areas has been a vital part of its ability to remain competitive in the future. Ha, itu kelebihan. Ha, itu cerita real story about apa. Kemana dia combine, how important is what? Important is IP, intellectual apa? Property. With that, I think that is enough for today lah. Aku 12.55, you pun nak rehat semua. Okay. So yang you punya tu hari ni 15 due kan, ada dah masuk. Saya akan at the end of this hari ni saya akan masuk semua lah. Check semua sekali. Tengok balik you punya ni. Of course banyak juga lah nak baca berapa ratus. Berapa puluh orang punya tu. Anyhow, of course lah. Thanks a lot lah yang dah hantar. Tapi masih ada masa lagi lah bagi siapa yang belum hantar lagi. Hari ni kan dia kan 15 kan? 15 kan? Hello? 15 kan?
Okay. Yes, sir.
Saya tengok di ada nanti saya masuk dalam link. Okay. Itu aje lah. Any question? Ada apa question lagi? So, saya rasa kita dah kena explore, dapat ilmu baru juga. Saya pun sama-sama juga. Still learning lah. Saya selalu kata Lisa, saya selalu belajar benda yang baru. Story-story ni, we collect the real story lah. So, kalau you nak check memang kita tu lah, macam value of one lah. Saya ada sini tapi tak ingat nak buka kat mana. Value of trade secret, bukan trade secret. Dia punya copyright ni cukup tinggi hari ni. Kalau McDonald's berapa bilion tau, semua bilion-bilion, tak ada murah-murah lah. Google punya, Microsoft punya, semua haknya. And even Microsoft pun dia pergi beli syarikat kecil juga. Apa yang berlaku di Malaysia, di negara lain pun sebenarnya ada yang datang ke Malaysia kadang real story ni kan. Ada seorang real business entrepreneur. Dia set up company under certain name. Orang tu nak expand business to Malaysia. Orang lain beli kerana dia punya copyright tentang nama company dengan apa semua. Itu ada easy money datang. So we never know about it. Because after we appreciate the value of IP, intellectual property. Okay. With that, I think if you kalau ada question, you can question me. If not, kita end our session today. And hopefully, kita will proceed further lah. InsyaAllah kita akan habis ibu kita. and you have the task to do, and of course very challenging that you have you're supposed to but we have to do during your ni lah ENT ni course ni lah. Okay, alright everybody, can we end the today punya session today? Boleh?
Yes. Boleh sir.
Okay, semua dah isi dia punya attendant hari ni?
Sudah sir.
Dah. Okay, thank you.
Sudah.
Okay, bye.
Thank you sir.
Thank you.
Assalamualaikum. Nyok. Bunyi apa kira-kira? Awak tu.